five oils tonight that I want each of you to smell. And I want you to just smell it and take it in. Try to keep track what repulses you, what resonates with you. And I'm going to tell you a little brief overlay of what they are. This is black pepper, the oil of unmasking, greatest oil of addiction. And it just strips us of the masks that we wear. Lemongrass, the oil of cleansing. It cleanses our emotional body like none other. What do you got, girlfriend? And then we'll pass them around. Thyme, powerful, total, deep, goes deeply into the body to break up all the emotional energies, the negativity, the toxins. Bergamot, just a beautiful emotional leveler. I'll go into more detail. Oh, and then Siberian fir, it's even better branded at. Now what I want you to do, smell it and then pass it around. And what I want you to realize, so.
What was this called again?
What do you got? Bergamot?
Bergamot.
All right, so for you Bergamot people, like, love that. That's the oil of self-acceptance.
That was priceless.
Oh, I like that.
So,
are we allowed to dot ourselves?
Yeah, if you find one that you really love, right?
Okay.
Smell it, put a little bit on your wrist or in your palm, rub it, smell it. And I could tell you more, but I'm going to give you all this to take home. So what did you smell so far? Siberian fir, so the white fir, just so I make sure. That's the, this is about generational healing. Siberian fir takes care of ancestral karma. Okay, some of the stuff that you don't like, thyme, we need the most. The thyme is the oil of releasing and forgiving. It's one of the powerhouses of release and forgiveness. The bergamot, we said, oil of self-acceptance.
Oh, I like
the
that.
Very sweet, beautiful. Oh, yeah. The lemongrass, that's the oil of cleansing. And the black pepper, unmasking. That's the truth. That's unmasking in terms of
like
that's the one we need. The one we don't like, I hate it, lavender. The one you don't like. Tell me. And you put it, cut it with the coconut oil on the soles of your feet.
Right.
And you use it. Which one is it? This is the black pepper.
I didn't get that for you.
Oil of alkaline. Okay, she's got it. Well, every one of these is for authenticity. It's just stripping ourselves. All right.
Red.
Red's liking us.
All
right, so the one that you do like, smell it up.
What you don't like is what you need?
Usually.
Really?
Typically. The one that smells, look, when our resonance, they say, think about this. You know how, like, somebody bugs the hell out of you, and you think, oh, I hate this person. Typically, that's your soulmate. Because the universe only brings the people that we are not to learn from and not in this lifetime to be within proximity. We will never meet in this whole lifetime. We will not. Those that come for whatever reason, a minute, a day, a year, a season, they're there to give you your mirror, to let you do your work, whether it's acceptance, whether it's forgiveness, whether it's humility, whatever it is.
I think some people are just there to fuck with you.
But it's all...
that was very well done.
And
very authentic.
Similarly, it's in the contrast, right, that in the duality that we expand, that we grow.
Or people who have their own issues, and it just impacts you no matter what.
But there, nobody's our business, not at all. Your kids, your husband, nobody's any of your business. The relationship, the business of understanding the dynamic and the growth and the learning is the only thing of importance. Everybody's journey is unique. We have nothing to do with that.
Right.
So as soon as we judge and have anything to say negative about anybody, it's our problem, it's our stuff. Nobody's our problem. Everything's our interpretation. everything's our story.
See, here's the thing though. I really think people, we are social beings, and people's energy and their, wherever their shit is, impacts you.
Well, why is that? Because your energy, listen, you are everything.
I can have an interaction like that, and all of a sudden I walk away and I don't feel like myself anymore. But I don't feel like myself. I don't feel like I feel like I'm in somebody else's skin.
Well, because you didn't protect your energy. All I'm saying is pay attention to the fact that we're an inner radio. It's all we are.
Yeah.
And when I'm grounded and when I'm resilient.
Yeah, when I'm more grounded, you're right.
When I'm not tired, wiped out,
it doesn't affect me as much.
If I am aware of my energy, nobody's going to take me off my wobble.
That's probably true.
It is true. And the only reason you're getting sucked in is because you have stuff alive in your pain body, in your frequency.
Okay.
There's things you're still unaware of that somebody's triggering in you and activating.
Okay.
You're reacting at that subliminal, subconscious level.
Could be the pain body. I know about the pain body.
Yeah.
But we're not conscious of those things.
Maybe.
But the point is, the end of blame. As we become aware, more consciously aware, blame doesn't exist. When we find ourselves telling a story and blaming, it's our stuff.
Right.
If we stick to, we got to grow up, we got to be responsible, we take accountability. Now, if we have a choice, you don't have to be in the toxic energy. You know, we have that choice. Then we take action. But the action is from a grounded place of love. When we act out of fear and unawareness, it's always wrong. Mm-hmm. It's always going to take us out of alignment. But when we're centered, when we're grounded, when we're authentic, I know who I am. I know why I'm here. I know what I'm to do. It comes from Him. It comes from greater consciousness. It comes from Source. And when I'm aligned with that, everything flows. When I'm not aligned, I'm pulled sensory. I'm pulled by the things of the world externally. And I'm going to always be out of alignment. So just keep things to think about. I'm going to send this with you. The oils too. Before we start, what we talked about, I have 8 little things. We talked about authenticity. Do me a favor, read me your affirmation, nice and loud.
Says, I am becoming more and more myself every day.
All right. I am becoming more and more myself every day. That goes out to the group. We are one self here. When you're not good, I'm not good. I'm only as good as the last common denominator. And we think, spiritual awakening, you're racing to the finish line. It's all bullshit. When you get here, you got to wait till everybody catches up. So our goal and our mission is to become helpers, and we help facilitate the awakening of others with patience and all of that. What's your say?
I am a unique masterpiece.
I am a unique masterpiece.
Yes.
Each of us is, right? Mm-hmm. We all have some gift. When we're little, we think it's a curse, but we're stepping into that quirky self, right? And loving it. Because God made us very different. What do you got?
No, I just wanted to share that Reggie's such a
What's
cool
yours say?
Oh, I'm sorry. Mine says, I am enough. I am enough.
I am enough.
I'm enough.
Gail's enough. We're all enough. Unique masterpiece. Becoming myself. What do you got?
My work makes a difference. It matters.
My son got that today. My work makes a difference. It matters. All of our work. Right? What do you got?
I will never trade my authenticity for approval.
I will never trade my authenticity for approval. Right. What do you have, Chris?
I love myself.
I love myself.
That's a good one.
I'm open to all of the wealth life presents me with.
I'm open to all the wealth that life presents me with.
Authenticity means I have the courage to be myself.
And it takes courage. Is it easy to be ignorant of bliss? Yeah, I used to say, why do I have to tell the truth all the time? Everybody else is lying. Why do I have to do this? Nobody else is, when I was kind of stepping in. Till you wake up and you have that dark night of the soul and you realize it's a lonely journey. as you start to awaken, and those around you, closest to you, just are right there and making life so much harder. And it's lonely because you feel like, well, I'm really alone. Until you kind of come out of that a little bit. We'll talk more about that.
Well, people right. don't want to hear the truth. A lot of people.
And it's none of our business. Right. So we keep doing truth for me. Mm-hmm. Truth for me. Humbly. The work doesn't have to be. And like when we're early awakening, we think everybody's got to get it. And we right. want to go, don't you know this? And don't you know? And we become like a, you know, a know-it-all spiritually.
Right.
Yeah. But God wants us to be quiet. And he wants us to pray in a way that's devotional and not making a big scene. Not making a, just living right, living through example. And just your presence alone makes all the difference energetically. It's not what you say. Because the people that are saying a lot, if you look at the powers to be and they're imploding, it's all BS.
Right.
It's falling, the false powers. But, you know, if you're just true and it's not there to be on Facebook and you're not trying to get all the likes and you're not trying to get out there to make money, the abundance comes. The wealth of the universe will provide, but it's always when it's in alignment. Right? And keep it in mind tonight, we're one system here, one organism helping one another. So when we feel pain and we want to cry or show emotion, we help one another to get that out. All right, so.